So we are actually at the Sulaja embankment dam, the close view, and I'm here with Mr. Willy. He recently just returned from a trip. Mr. Willy, how have you been?
I've been fine. I was in the Netherlands for almost over 3 weeks, actually. So let's go back to Sulaja and see how the thing has developed.
Indeed.
In 1 month's time. I've not been here for 2 months almost.
Indeed.
Because most of the time I'm in Takum, like you know.
Indeed, indeed.
And so when we came here, we saw my friend fishing. He's a Lebanese guy.
Oh yeah.
He's already here all his life. He speaks Hausa, like a Hausa man. And he's a very good fisherman, but this is not the right time to fish. He said the water level is too high.
Indeed.
All the fish are hiding in the grasses.
Indeed, yeah. Indeed.
So, but he's getting now maybe some tilapia, but normally he catch Nile perch.
It's interesting, you know.
Because the Nile perch is very cost.
Yes.
He sells them to some expensive supermarkets, Lebanese supermarkets in Abuja.
Mm-hmm.
So his major goal is to get Nile perch. So at the moment, he catch more tilapia.
The parent stock of the Nile perch you put in that farm is from this place, I guess, right?
Yes, it's from him, because I got small ones from him.
Oh.
And next time when I want to go for fishing, let me check if they're still there, if nobody has catch them already.
Okay.
And see how big they are, because last time they were about 30 to 40 centimeters.
Mm.
That is 1 year ago, and they can grow very fast if there's enough small fish for them to eat. Because Nile perch is obligatory carnivorous fish.
Oh, they don't eat any other thing but other insects and
no,
fishes?
No, when they are very small, they eat insects, but when they get to a size, let's say 5 to 10 centimeters, I think they only eat other fish. They are serious predator fish.
Interesting, huh? Interesting. So, I see the action is really going on nicely, seriously around here.
Yeah, they're getting now to the point you should start to see fish. And I see some movement of the water there.
Yeah,
that means there's fish inside that. The net is there.
Amazing.
So now they're dragging the under net.
Yeah? Yeah.
Because the under net is far away. This is called a drag net.
Mm.
Yeah, but he told me that most of the fish now they do spawning. See, there's a lot of small fish in the grasses everywhere.
Yes.
Because the water level is very high.
Exactly.
The spawning season is most of the time in the raining season, not in the dry season.
I guess.
There's a reason for it, because in the raining season when the water level goes up,
yes,
these grasses are standing underwater. Some deteriorate, it gives a lot of plankton.
Yes.
That is the food for the small larvae fish.
Mm.
So there's a reason for it that those things are happening. The spawning is happening in the raining season,
yes,
because of food. Apart from the tilapia, because they spawn the whole year
too. I get.
But most other fish in the lake, they are not multi-spawners, they are spawning only once in a season.
I get. This is interesting. And just so the viewers can know, it's not like these ones are like tilapias that raised themselves and grew themselves.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Nobody's.
This is a dam. All the fish, in fact, here is natural fish.
Okay.
Natural fish.
Natural fish.
Yeah.
And. Like you once mentioned that these ones most likely they have more they eat more of the real thing, insects and everything.
They eat only natural food, and that's why, of course, because they rely on the natural food, the density can never be as in the fish pond.
Exactly.
Because in the fish pond you are going to feed them. Yeah, so it is not comparable. This is natural production, and of course if there's too much fishing, but he's the only one fishing with the net. Some people are fishing with hook.
Yeah.
So I think altogether there's not too much overfishing here.
I understand. Can we say that this tilapia raised here naturally would most likely be more nutritious than the one raised in the pond?
I think, to be honest, yes.
Mm.
Because they eat a more variated feed.
Yes.
So, and that means that it's not highly intensive growing.
Yes.
I believe that the taste will be slightly different, but also that the nutritional value,
yeah,
will also a bit better. I believe that. It's not much, but it is, of course, it's a different, because you eat, you are what you eat.
Indeed, indeed.
You eat what you are what you eat.
Indeed.
So is the variation of food is more. It would also reflect on the meat.
Indeed. So, suddenly, this is fishing, this is not fish farming.
No, it has nothing to do with fish farming at all.
And aquaculture is actually when you do fish farming or you farm other aquatic animals, you domesticate them.
Aquaculture is farming all kinds of aquatic animals.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that can be anything, fish, shrimps, lobster.
Mm-hmm.
Crocodile, not really, because it's a reptile.
Yes.
But even seaweed is also a form of aquaculture.
I guess.
Anything grow in the water is a type of aquaculture.
So, I'm always very curious to ask, even though, of course, at the backdrop here, just like our viewers can see, there is a very interesting action happening here as they are bringing out the tilapia, most likely other things.
Big fish, but it doesn't look like big fish today, because if there was a big nail push inside,
it will start jumping up.
Now they're cleaning the net. Yeah, one drag will take them some time.
Yeah.
They have to put the net somewhere and then they drag it out. I think it will take them more than an hour, 1.5 hours.
Yeah. You know,
if you can go front, maybe you can see me.
I see a lot of shells on the floor here. These are shells of...
These are freshwater mussel.
Mm.
Yeah. My wife has once eaten them. She almost died from it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Now, still,
it is possible that the sludge, because they're eating they're filtering the water, they say. They're eating the sludge, so if the water is polluted, all the poison will be inside them.
Just like you rightly mentioned now, that just like a man is what he eats. The fish is also, or the animal in the water,
yes,
they are what they eat.
It is the same thing. What they eat is what they are. So this mussel, if they are in the polluted sludge,
yes.
So they will also be polluted with the chemicals in the sludge. It's the same thing.
So aquaculture seeks to increase the availability of these aquatic, consumable animals for man.
They don't even want to take it out.
No, they'll take it out now.
Oh, they take it out.
Yes, you know, I was going to mention, this is all as a result of the early rainy season, I guess.
No, the rainy season is not a good time of fishing. Yeah, in the dry season, the water also level is going to be smaller. The grasses are not occupied with water.
Yes.
So it's easier to catch fish. And he told me that the rainy season in this dam has started very early.
Which is... Which is normally the water level at this point should be 3 months into, and it's coming 3 months earlier, I guess.
Since in June.
The dam here is being filled up since
June. Oh my word! Oh no!
Nothing.
Oh no!
Let me see if you see a small. I see a small map. See this one?
That's a nail perch.
Yeah, you see this is a small nail perch. Guiarua.
Guiarua.
You see the eye? Very big.
Yes, some bulging eye there.
You know, the fact that eye is big means that he is predating with his eye. A catfish is not predating with the eye because he has the barbels. This one, he cannot eat very well in a very green water. No good for him.
And this one only eats live prey.
Only live.
Oh,
this one on this size.
Only live prey.
Yes.
That's important. So it is not easy to domesticate a Nile perch. If you want to feed them with the normal feed.
Get them on dry feed.
They can't go up on dry feed.
Can they be trained to eat?
Except if you get fish and throw for them. Like Mr. Willy has at the pond. So he put tilapia first. So when the tilapia started getting birth, then we introduced Nile perch so that they can also
eat the offspring.
I get.
But it's not an intensive system.
I get. That was an experimental thing, right? Or what was the reason?
I want to start looking at those fish now. Because if they have abundant feed, they can grow 40 centimeters in a year's time.
Yes.
They grow very fast if they have enough feed.
The fish that is there when we kept it is about almost a kilo. Or some are less than a kilo. Some are about 30, 40, 50 grams.
Mm.
But now, after a couple of years, they should be more than a kilo, 2 kilos, 3 kilos.
Even more.
Depending on the feed. Yeah. And there's a lot of tilapia there, so...
Which is what they eat, the nile perch.
Yes. Tilapia. They eat any fish alive, any fish that they see alive. They
eat it. Even that little one we saw just now can actually eat a small fry.
Let me show you one big tilapia.
That is what?
This is tilapia. We also have nile perches that eat this. This one is even.
No way.
There's a nile perch we can eat this size.
No way.
Because we have nile perches here 50, 60, 70, 80 kilos.
Wow.
Huh?
Yes, one nile perch, 70 kilos, 60 kilos. I have caught them. Can she come out?
How many years would you think would have made, I mean, led to that size? Maybe they've existed for like how long?
No, maximum they can, to get to that size, depending on the feed. The more they feed,
the bigger they grow.
And here is abundant with tilapia and other species. And it's an invasive species, this Nile perch.
It multiplies also very hard because he told me now in the air in this grass,
there
are many of them.
Even your own in the airport.
I think they born as well. I saw different type.
They're born.
I saw not tilapia's fry. I saw other fry.
They are.
So these are the nile perches then.
Yeah, we're going to go to the pond now. The pond has become very beautiful, or not?
Yes.
Very nice. Huh?
The only thing that the problem that we will have there to catch those fishes.
The grass.
We can't catch the fishes there. Even if we catch what we catch, the others are inside the grass.
Yes, they will turn into the edge of the water. This actually is a benefit. So it's good to catch them with hook.
Yes,
with hook.
Yes.
You know, when I see this, this you have seen is disappointing, but in the big picture, is this a sign that in years to come, you might hardly find fish inside this water?
No. That's not impossible. The fish that we have in this dam here, it can never go out.
Because many are hidden within the grasses and...
Because the fish in the dam here, they born every 3, 4, 5, 6 months. They give birth. You understand? So in a year, they give birth twice. At the beginning of the rainy season.
Even every 5 weeks.
Yeah. The beginning of the rainy season and in the end. And every fish like this Nile perch.
Yes.
You can see maybe a couple of 4, 5, 6, 7,000 eggs.
Oh my world.
Even more. This is just a little. The tilapias also that are here. When they are little, the mother opens her mouth.
Mm.
And they all go inside when they see a predator. After the predator has gone, they spit them out and they carry on feeding.
They are mole feeders. They call it mole feeding.
So that one you brought is a female?
That's a tilapia.
It's a tilapia,
no,
but
you don't check if it is.
You can't know whether
male.
Oh, it's difficult to tell just by seeing them.
Well, it's difficult because the only time you can tell whether they're males or females is whenever you catch them and they start
giving egg.
Before they come out of the water, they...
So the reproductive system is not anywhere visible?
It's not visible.
For me as a fish farmer, it is visible only when they're adult. But if you strip them and the egg is coming out, you are 100% sure.
Yes, when you squeeze them.
But if you squeeze them and there's no egg coming out, you are not sure.
Mm.
You can only guess.
This is amazing, to be honest. And when I look at this, still talking about the fact that what they eat is what they are, I keep wondering, these things are feeding on a lot of insects or whatever inside the water, the tilapia
fishes,
now.
There are fishes that feed on insects.
Okay.
Just like these tilapias that you saw.
Yes.
They only feed on mud. That's what they eat.
So there's larvae inside.
There's
so many little things inside what they eat. They even eat all the bentos in the water, they eat. But they are not really predators.
They're not predators. All they eat is mud. But the ones that they are putting inside farms,
yes,
they make them eat those pellets. But even if you eat those ones, it's just like eating a natural chicken.
And eating an agri chicken.
It's just like eating a natural fish and eating a...
fish that is given, a pelletized meal.
Yes. So, of course, this fish that we catch here are harder to catch and more tastier.
But then, of course, they will not be sufficient to feed everybody if you are to rely on them. That is the reason for aquaculture, I guess.
Yeah, the reason why it's not enough for all of us is because that the insurgency that's going on. Otherwise, we have abundant fish in Nigeria that can feed everybody. In all these big dams, all these rivers, all these canals.
Yes.
There are thousands and thousands of different species, and more especially this river, this dam that is from Cameroon that comes in all the way to Lokoja.
Okay, okay.
They're blue and black.
Yes.
These are mixed together.
Yeah.
You know, there's a blue and black.
Oh, really?
In that Lokoja, they mix.
The confluence.
Yes. You see the blue one and white one, they mix together. That is, most of the water is coming from other countries around Nigeria.
And so they come with a lot of fish species and a lot more fish.
And more especially now, this place that they did here in Zengeru, that hydroelectric.
Okay.
That they blocked. So all the fish now are...
They stop there.
Instead of them to carry on going. So they are blocked there.
You know, so fishing is a profession that cannot end.
It can't end.
But of course, how many people know that they can still do it? It's still a question. Or have what it takes, like what you're doing here.
Yeah, you see some people that want to catch Nile perches and other fishes. They normally use hooks.
Yes.
When they use hooks, they get live bait. You understand?
Yes.
They put the live bait on the hook, and maybe they have 100 hooks.
Yes.
So they have 100 live baits. So what they do, they make a line for about maybe 500 meters of rope. Every 10 meters,
they have a hook with a live bait.
With a bottle.
Okay, okay.
Coke or Fanta,
to suspend the
no, to hold it up.
You know where the rope is, you can find it back.
When it starts shaking, you know what?
Yes.
No, you don't do that. You just come in the morning and you will have it.
Yes. And then also another thing is, if you don't put that bottle at the top, whenever the fish go, you catch a fish,
it
goes down.
It takes it away.
It can go down and get caught in stones or trees or twigs or whatever. So that bottle, when the fish goes down, the bottle of air brings it back up. So by the time you come and to remove it from the hook, it's already worn down. So that's another advantage. Other people use nets, 4 fingers, 5 fingers.
Like he's doing.
So yes. The net, do you think is, you would have done the hook if you are sure that some people will not go take your net. That's your thing. That's why a net is real time.
No, this net that we do is because we want to do it in front of us and go.
You don't want to wait and keep it for days before you come.
Because by the time we come back, they have already looted our property. You put nets, you put hooks, you put whatever. Now, by the time you come back the next day,
somebody has taken it. You know, it's quite. I guess you've been in this business for quite a while. I don't know, like how many years, because your experience speaks volume.
I was normally a hunter and trapper for wild animals. So due to the insurgency and the security system factor,
yes,
that's why we turn now to become fishermen. And we've been doing this now for the past about 17, 18 years now.
You are a Nigerian then?
Yes, I'm a Lebanese Nigerian, of course. I was born and brought up in Kaduna.
Born and brought up?
Yes, in Kaduna, but I did my education in London and in Italy.